This is incredible. It is amazing. There, everybody benefits off of this. This is how technology is changing everything. Welcome back to TMZ Live. And the restaurant industry is getting pretty creative, on how to keep open during the pandemic. And they can thank some big name celebs who are getting into the restaurant business in a way. It's called ghost kitchens. People like Mariah Carey, Steve Aoki, Pauly D even, and Guy Fieri are getting in on the ghost kitchen craze. This is where you have a pop-up restaurant that delivers. It's only delivery, and they're using existing kitchens to roll this out. So this has turned into a huge, huge business, and you can see them all over the country where they're where these things are popping up.
Hey, Charles, before we get to Damon, I've already got a name for Mariah's. Carry out.
That was actually good. That's actually really good.
That's why you didn't expect it, Damon, because it was good. Damon. So listen, this is this, you know, it seemed like this was a one-off. I think I want to say there was a rapper who did this last year.
Tyga did it.
But now everybody's doing it. Everyone's getting in on this.
This is incredible. It is amazing. Everybody benefits off of this. This is how technology is changing everything. But, you know, this is not totally new. Before COVID, they had what they call virtual kitchens and various other things where there was no physical retail space where people could sit, and they were just cooking out of, well, you know, various other locations and delivering it. Even Chuck E. Cheese had some kind of issue or maybe uptick because they had a cheese delivery, a pizza delivery called Pasquale's or something like that. And people were like, wait, isn't this Chuck E. Cheese? And they were like, well, you probably wouldn't have ordered a Chuck E. Cheese pizza. So,
right. Yeah.
Right?
That's hysterical. So, that's funny.
Hey, and it works. And it works. We're laughing, but it works, right?
But now, somebody named, Robert Earl, the founder of Planet Hollywood, came out with something called virtual dining concepts. And this is why it's so great. Somebody like a Mr. Beast came out with a Mr. Beast burger. Now, if you don't know who Mr. Beast is, he's the second highest paid YouTube star. He opened up 300 of these virtual kitchens around the country, dubbed the Mr. Beast burger, put out videos on YouTube, and had 45 million views, and you know what? 1 million burgers were sold in 2 months. Now, I want to break that down to you, because if this is getting complicated, people, let me explain what this is. You have a restaurant. You are already selling pizza. You do not sell burgers, but you are saying, listen, 50% or 30% of my time, I'm just sitting on my hands because my business has decreased. I will make the Mr. Beast burger under the Mr. Beast burger brand. You'll send me the boxes. You'll send me everything else, and we will deliver it from my restaurant. You do not know that it's coming from me, and I'm going to make, for every dollar sold, I'm going to make 30 cents. This is keeping people in business. So this is all around good. If you're a fan of Mr. Beast, or let's say I'm a fan of Patti LaBelle, but I can't get Patti LaBelle lasagna anywhere, I get it. Also, that YouTube star or that Patti LaBelle who has intellectual property, they make money. And at the end of the day, the restaurant, the 300 restaurants that are serving Mr. Beast burgers are now making 30 cents off of every single dollar, and Mr. Beast is doing all the advertising. This is amazing.
What a great idea. So,
for instance, I had checked the other night, Guy Fieri opened one near where I live, and I looked, I was about to order, but it didn't open that night until 8:15 p.m., which was too late to get the burger I wanted. I looked up the address, and it's a local Italian restaurant.
Exactly.
That they're using as the kitchen.
This is helping everyday restaurants. This is going to change technology. This is, and you know what? If you're a restaurant, you don't have to advertise it. You have somebody like Mariah Carey saying, because Mariah Carey has Mariah Carey cookies. Pauly D has Pauly D's Italian subs. Tyga has Tyga Bites with chicken tenders. So you don't even have to advertise it. They just go on the radio or say, hey, get my Tyga Bites, and you look it up, and boom, just like you did, you'll find out where that restaurant is. And or you'll order, it'll come to your house, and you saved in advertising, and you made money off of somebody else's fame or intellectual property or advertising.
Yeah.
The only remaining question, Damon, is should we call Mariah Carey and just and give her Harvey's great idea? I mean, I don't know what she was calling her cookie biz before, but obviously
I mean, mine's better.
Harvey beat me on the branding this time.
He beat you on puns. That's what he's good.
No. We're out of time, but I got to tell you something.
Here we go.
I made something last night. I make the best shrimp tacos on earth. I'm serious. Well, I took somebody's recipe to do it, actually.
Okay.
So I may get in touch with this guy because I'm telling you, these tacos are like crazy good. So you want to do your own shrimp taco pop-up? I do.
Talk about it enough. Keep talking about it enough. And you never know. People may say, hey, I want to check them out.
Hey, Damon, I got to tell you.
Tacos just doesn't, I don't know, something about it.
It doesn't feel right. Okay, well, this was fantastic. I love this. This was really interesting, Damon.
It's always great to end the week with somewhat of good news.
It is good news. It's great news. So yeah.
And news that makes you hungry, because now I really want to get that burger.
But Charles, he did mention if you really want to take care of yourself, maybe kind of lay off that late at night, Damon is saying. So anyway.
Thanks, Damon. We'll talk to you next week, man.
All right, later.